What's going on, guys? We are back with some more MLB The Show. Yeah, Brad Jameson, he could be someone we look at. Yeah, this could be a big moment for Josiah Gray. So we're gonna hop in.
Shall be alongside Chris Singleton. We'd like to welcome those just tuning in on the show for a live look in. You're right on time. Josiah Gray still on the mound to start this ninth inning. We'll see if he can wrap this one up and complete the shutout. Lopez in the box now. No balls and a strike.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Bunting for a hit. And that's just foul. Left-hand hitter waits. To third. Dives.
Ground ball. Senzel can't.
It appears Dave Martinez is ready. Hunter Harvey taking over on the mound.
Well, a low scoring ball game in this one. 2-0 game, few errors, pretty clean. That's kind of what you want to see in terms of defense and pitching. A couple of runs was all it took to get a W today.
2-0, your final here in this.
Josiah Gray looks to be your future ace. Kip rubber match against our division rivals.
Thank you.
respectfully, Carter Kubel getting. Get off the 40 man. Okay, yep, we're gonna do it. And yeah, we're gonna make a trade. He's struggling in Triple I. Yeah, Mets will not be able to do it. Cubs got money. Yeah, Keegan's not doing bad. Yeah, I move Cruz in the starting lineup. Here we go. It's Nationals Phillies. And welcome today.
Now the left fielder, Eddie Rosario. The pitch. And that's outside. And we are underway. Swings through the fastball up in the zone.
Definitely not a pitch location you're expecting up there as a hitter when you know the guy's got a good sinker ball. If you can get in that location, boy, you've got to look top to bottom, and that's going to make it very difficult to hit.
Turner makes the grab, one down. At the plate, Dylan Cruz looking for his first big league hit right here.
That's foul away. Number 13 prospect, number 3 center field prospect.
Just missed. Cruz making his debut in the middle of the season after missing out of the opening day roster. I don't think anyone surprised the former first rounder made it to this level. It was more a question of when and not if, Singy. Right through there for a strike.
Yeah, as you say, Boog, it's something we've been waiting for him to get here. We knew all along it was going to happen at some point.
That's going to be foul.
He's going to focus on whatever it takes to stay up here.
Kicks and deals. Spoils
foul
that
way again.
Remains 2-2. One down, base is empty. And they'll do it again. Comes a 2-2.
And that's a blooper in the left, and they'll get down.
He forced a lot of pitches to be thrown and ends up collecting a hit. Dylan Cruz with his first major league hit, and this is a moment I'm sure he'll never forget. Congrats.
Yeah, great moment for him and his family. A guy works so hard and has to wait so long for this to happen, and when it does, can kind of be overwhelming, Boog. You still have to stay locked in on the game, but it's great when you could take a minute to just appreciate what you've done and how hard you worked to get here.
Joey Meneses stands in now and watches strike one.
Yeah, it doesn't really have the speed.
That one finds the zone, and it's 0-2.
Well, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes, even a good pitch early in the at-bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
Just missing there. Now 1-2.
It's a good take.
Ground ball.
That's on the ground. They get one, and they get two.
bases and no one left. And now it's the Phillies' turn. No score. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Trey Turner at the plate. Hard hit left side.
Ground ball's first.
Short. One up, one down. Whit Merrifield up to the plate. In there at the knees.
Throughout history, the fastball down has been the most successful pitch. Guys can handle a little bit better these days, but they, of course, still prefer something belt high.
And here it comes. In the dirt.
Jackson Rutledge takes the ball.
Couldn't chase that time. Kicks and fires. And another ball. Foul ball.
That ball's fouled away by Merrifield.
Swing and he breaks his bat. Whips it to Gallo.
Rutledge.
And the whole first moving along quickly today. Two gone.
Absolutely sawed him off. Bat explodes. Harper. And then he makes an easy play on it. Pretty satisfying if you're out there on the ball.
And a foul ball. Two outs. And a foul ball. And a pitch. That's off the mark. Gonna count one and two.
Overrated.
Down quickly go the Phillies. Scoreless after one. Second inning set to go. Joey Gallo steps to the plate. There's a strike.
He's been known to jump all over the first pitch, so that seems like a missed opportunity right there.
Just missed.
That's for yeah, sure with the shift.
And now the lefty. Not even close there. Now 2-2. This to third.
And that's against the shift, but the one man over there makes the play.
Quickly one away in the second. Now it's Nick Senzel. 0 for 6 in the series so far. And first offering is fouled off. No score here in the second. Short snagged on a bounce. Turner with the throw to first. Two up, two down.
Yeah, and now it's Keeper Ruiz.
Hitless of the first two games of the series. He's 0 for 8. Ball. That one off the mark. And that is ball one. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Left side. Two outs, base is empty. On the ground to third.
That's down line. Fair ball.
Fair. And now it's Luis Garcia.
And that ball's down the line. It has a chance. Gone! Big fly for Luis Garcia.
spot. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. Okay. It was like BP all over again.
Lane Thomas in the box here lets that one go for a ball. Base is empty, two away, but two runs are in here in the third and final game of the series. That one lifted to left.
That ball hit hard, but not deep enough.
Makes the catch.
Because Harper makes the catch.
But two come across to score in the inning, courtesy of this two-run homer. It's back in Citizens Bank Park. Kyle Schwarber comes up to hit here. In the air.
That ball. Get over the wall for a double. That ball's gonna get down.
Center field. That gets down for a hit. The throw in. It's off the mark and he scores.
Well done. Drives in the run. That ball right there landed in what they call a no man's land, meaning it's.
Here's the pitch. Runner breaks for third.
And the throw gets by him.
Headed for the plate. He scores to tie it up. It's 2-2.
And we're tied at 2.
Catches the low inside corner. Good fastball. Two runs across in the inning. Bottom half of inning number two. Next offering is in for a strike. Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Johan Rojas, batting with one down, takes a strike. And that one fouled off.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
Got him looking.
And there's two down. Here's Christian Punchin.
It's been a tough stretch for him at the plate. Only two hits over the last five games.
The 0-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. 2013 in the playoffs, you caught one as the Red Sox played the Rays in the division series.
I sacrificed a bracelet. It was my wrist and my hand.
He's got it, and that'll do it. They get two and draw even again. We play two full. Back here, Citizens Bank Park.
I bet the Phillies just showed how quickly they can get back into a game.
This is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
That clips the corner.
The TJ Abrams is almost at 300.
Fights that one away. The count remains.
So, yes, so that's positive.
The pitch. One that ball. One not he's close. Hit. Ball one.
That's down the line. Fair balls.
Makes the turn and heads for second. It's a leadoff double to start the third.
And a leadoff double for CJ Abrams.
Stretch the plate lately. Nice line drive.
That flaw.
Headed out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Here's Eddie Rosario. He's 0 for 1. Ball one, no strikes. And there's a ball.
Two balls, no strike.
Ball
That's foul away.
And it's second.
Got him swinging. Dylan Cruz.
The single so far.
Where he has the first hit.
Foul ball there. One out and a runner at second. We're here in the top half of inning number three. Next offering is foul back. Still 0-2. The pitch.
One and two.
In the dirt. Runner holds. Count goes to 1-2. Next pitch is outside. Abrams leads off second with one gone in the inning. On the ground. Trey Turner gloves it. That's the second out.
Two down.
Joey Meneses will hit next. And there's a foul.
That ball's crushed foul.
Second, two down here in the rubber match of this three-game series.
That's foul away.
And ball one.
Pitches up.
Through the early stages. He hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Wouldn't chase that time. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. And another ball. Second, two down. That one down.
Gets down the line, and what a play! The first is in time! Bison Scott, stop. It just robs the Nationals of a run.
Same pitcher twice in the same inning. Only a few players have ever done it, and his were against his former team, the Washington Nationals.
It's softly on the ground, left side, and they get
first is in time.
Late bite on that slider, got the hitter out in front, rolled over on it. Exactly what it was supposed to do.
And digging in for Philadelphia, Whit Merrifield. First pitch misses. Merrifield getting the start at second. 35 years old, and he was selected to the All-Star game last year. Fastball for a strike, and now it's even 1-1.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Two gone now. Bryce Harper to the plate. That just misses, and it's 1-0. Harper, multi-time All-Star, hitting third in the lineup, a former first-round pick back in 2010.
Well, he looks more focused at the plate and working the count after that first at-bat strikeout.
That's towards
that ball's in the air center. Cruz is there.
Over. And tied it to a piece.
And welcome back to the ballpark. John Chompy with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Joey Gallo. Suarez back to work. That one finds the zone. That's strike one.
You know, these Nationals did a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way.
And that ball's crushed.
Way back there, on its way. Gone.
And Gallo goes yard.
He sends it out of here. It's 3-2. That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it. Hits it out of the ballpark. Here's the third baseman, Nick Senzel. They say it went.
0-1.
And Senzel gives one a drive foul.
A leadoff home run in an inning kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
That one almost got him. Straightened him up a little bit. One run across in the frame so far. Top half of inning number four. Just off the outside part of the plate.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Gets a piece and stays alive.
That's fouled away.
And that's down and away.
3-2 pitch.
Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these two are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more and more.
And he walked him.
Hasn't been a ball in play yet. When you go that deep into the bat, the hitter usually comes out.
Hebert Ruiz digging in for the Nationals. 1-for-1 with a single and a run scored so far. Right through there for a strike. Short.
On the ground.
Goes to second. Safe there. To first, and he's out. So safe at second. Out at first on the attempted double play. Now it's the second baseman, Luis Garcia. He's already homered here in this one. Fastball for a strike. And it's 0-1. Stirring in the Phillies bullpen, Spencer Turnbull up and throwing. Walker also getting ready. Fought off foul. Behind 0-2, he steps out for time. One out and a runner at second here in the third and final game of the series. And that's outside.
Send them pitches.
On the ground, right side. Real Muto to first. Got the out. Here's Lane Thomas. Flied to left his first time.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys can take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion, and he's in full speed.
Here comes the 0-1. Down to ball here, rolls foul. Two outs and a runner at third here in the rubber match of this three-game series.
And he got him.
Dirt swing and a miss. Real Muto. Soto up with it. Fires the first. And it's in time for the third out, so that'll end the inning.
But Gallo goes yard.
This solo home run. It's now a 3-2 ball game. Bottom four, here's the Phillies DH, Kyle Schwarber. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter.
Over 80% of his first pitches are strikes. You're doing that, you could have a really good day out there on the mound.
Pitch misses, and the count is 1-1. And that's outside.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
Swings through that one.
What the hell do you think I was throwing? Jesus. He was way out from that. He got it.
This has struck him out. Chris, as we look back at the pitch sequence, he hadn't seen that curveball at all. How tough is it to adjust to something like that with a bunch of break when you haven't had a look at it yet?
Yeah, I mean, you're dialed up for something firm. You never want to take a called third strike as a fastball, so you're going to be a little anxious before you recognize the pitch. And right there, clearly didn't see what was coming.
Real Muto in the box now. No balls and a strike. In the air, left field.
Rosario's there.
Rosario makes the catch. And that quickly, two away.
Two down.
This is Bryson's stop. Base hit, center field. Joey gets on base and keeps it going. And here is Sosa to the plate. On the ground to third, Senzel.
Senzel fires in time.
The runs, one hit, no errors, and a man left. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Nationals 3 and the Phillies 2. Back here in Philadelphia, the batter will be the shortstop, C.J. Abrams. And he deals. The shortstop takes the ball.
Well, these Nats doing a good job of simply getting the bat on the ball in this game, and the numbers back that up. The numbers tell us they're averaging more than a hit every inning, and they've only struck out twice, so they keep finding ways to put their bat on the ball.
To the right side, and he handles it himself for the out. Eddie Rosario getting ready to hit. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one.
Buga never got to play at Citizens Bank Park in my career. Just the old Veterans Stadium in Philadelphia. But the crowds here are just as energetic now as they were at that old park. And trust me, as an outfielder visiting town, you're going to hear it from the fans out there in the bleachers.
That one inside. And that's ball one.
Yeah.
Chase that time.
Suarez looks to be on his game now.
That one to first.
And that's down the line.
He's been swinging it really well. He turned on it nicely. Definitely a little out in front of the pitch, but he didn't hook around it too much and was able to keep it fair down the line.
Yeah, the batter now, Dylan Cruz. And that's in there at the knees for a strike. Rosario leads off first with one away. Right through there for a strike.
Now, he may have not liked either of those first two pitches or agreed with the umpire's calls, but at this point, he's going to have to bear down and be ready to hit anything close to the zone.
The 0-2. On the ground is short, could be two. Over to second for one.
Not in time.
It's a fielder's choice. Joey Meneses digging in for the Nationals. And the first pitch misses for ball one.
There's a pitch. pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Two outs. That one ran inside, almost got him. And this is inside.
3-1.
The 3-1. And he walks it.
Boo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at bats?
Ooh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report,
Spencer
Turnbull on a pitch out of the pen here.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Gallo at the plate now, and that's inside. And fouled off.
Get out, ball.
On two ball count, you can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
That misses the zone, and it count is 3-1. Nick Senzel up next.
3 balls, 1 strike. Here we go.
Hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
2 on, 2 outs. Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. The pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
And that ball's hit high and deep, and that ball is gone!
And it's gone! Home run! It just got out of here. His second home run of the game.
6-0.
It's 7-2. He kept swinging, and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle, Boog, and he just kept taking his cuts. Finally squared one up. He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch in that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrist to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the loft, and gets the home run.
Gallo does it again.
2 down, nobody on. And it's fouled away. Here's the 0-2. Stays alive.
The swing.
Real Muto to first. That ends the frame. But the biggest swing of the inning comes right here, a 3-run homer. Now a 6-2.
Joey Gallo goes yard.
It's Major League Baseball, and it's on. We head to the bottom of the fifth. And now here's a speed threat. Outfielder Johan Rojas. That one catches the zone. That's strike one.
You know, these Phils, from what we've seen, I think it's fair to wonder if they've been too patient at the plate. They found themselves behind in the count quite a bit. They're trying to be patient, but it's mostly resulting in outs, not base runners. And you could argue it's making things
down looking.
Struck him out looking.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
Gallo pulls it down, and there's 2 gone.
Batter number 7.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here's Turner now. That one close, ruled a ball. And that's ball 1. That one finds the zone, and the count even at 1.
The offense needs to start showing some fight against this starter. He's doing his thing out there. They're going to have to push back at some point and make him work a little bit harder.
And that one.
That's a base hit.
And that keeps the inning alive.
Just a simple ground ball the other way. They've got eyes on it, and sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, play, and just hope it finds a hole.
Whit Merrifield stands in for the Phillies. Runner on the goal. There's a ball. And safe. It's a stolen base. Chris, there aren't many players faster than him, and StatCast demonstrates that for us right here.
Yeah, it breaks down the data for us on a close play, and that top speed is about as fast as we've ever seen, Boog, and clearly it was the difference maker on that play.
Next pitch in for a strike, and it's 1-1. Towards right center field.
And Cruz makes a great catch.
And that ends the inning. One left for Philadelphia. They still trail it here. It's 6-2. Top of the sixth inning. And it's the catcher for the Nationals, Hebert Ruiz. The pitch. Look out. Turnbull goes 6 feet 3 inches. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a sinker, a changeup, and he occasionally uses a curve. Right through there for a strike. Next offering is in for a strike. Fights it off, he'll see another.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch, keep the at-bat alive.
And it's even up.
Well, this is a guy that can be frustrating for pitchers because he fouls off so many pitches and grinds out the at-bat. I'm sure there's some times where a pitcher would rather just give up a first pitch single than have to waste 6 or 7 pitches on one hitter.
Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Well, that high four-seam fastball has become such a staple as a strikeout pitch over the years. And what's so tough as a hitter is that you see it extremely well. The problem is the velocity and spin rate just happens to jump by you. You expand your zone, you don't stay tall on the backside, and you're really not even able to make contact. If you do, many times it's a pop-up.
That's a little bit low. Base is empty, one away, and we're the top half of the sixth. In the air, center field, Rojas on the move, hauls it in for the out. Lane Thomas now at the plate.
That ball will be caught. Into what?
Thomas measures 6 feet even, 28 years old, and he was a fifth round pick back in 2014. Swing and a pop up, foul out of play off to the right side. That'll find the stands. Swing
and he got him on the swing.
Real Muto up with it. Fires to first. That completes the strikeout, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for the. And we're back. Bottom of the sixth inning. And now here is Harper. And that one is lifted in the air. And it drops in. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. You know what they say, he couldn't have thrown it out there any better than that. And certainly the case that time, just flared it back behind the second baseman and dropped it in there.
And first off,
and now just deal with the Schwarber.
And the right-hander deals. And that one wrapped foul. The Phils down by 4 here in the bottom of the sixth. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Righty delivers. Hard on the ground to first.
Yes.
He takes it on his own. One away, bottom of the sixth.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind it with another ground ball. Good execution.
Check swing, tried to hold up, now an appeal to first. No swing, Earl Hendricks with the call. And it's second, foul ball. Late that time, and it's strike two.
Wow, good luck catching up to that one.
And that's in the dirt. Full count now.
3-2. And that's a base hit in the center.
Towards right center field. That'll touch down for a hit. The run comes in from second. It's 6-3.
Picks himself up at RBI. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Once in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity. Right on top of it. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
That clips the corner.
Don't play situation here. He's been working up in the zone. Typically, you look for guys to get that ground ball. See if he adjusts on this next pitch.
Righty to the plate.
And that's in the dirt. Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher. But if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself in the scoring position.
And the righty deals. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Real Muto leads off first with one away. On the ground right side, 4-6.
Not in time to first.
Good hustle, and the inning continues. Edmundo Sosa stands in for the Phillies. He's 0-1. He steps off, nothing going on at first. And there he goes. It's a pitch out.
And throw down, and he got him.
And that'll end it. Well, they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's now 6-3. You're dialed into the show. Back here, Citizens Bank. Citizens Bank Park, set for the last half of the seventh. So digging in now, Keegan Thompson takes over on the mound.
He doesn't get a lot of strikeouts compared to other relievers, so he relies on getting that soft contact and the defense doing work behind him. They'll have to be in their toes with him on the ball.
That one fouled off. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Rosario makes the catch, and there's one gone. Here's the center fielder, Johan Rojas. Ripped to the left center, base hit. So a man aboard now with one away. Christian Pache stands in for the Phillies. Slapped foul.
Now this team is definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
And a pitch. Foul ball. It stays nothing in two. Rojas, the base runner at first with one out. There.
Well, that's kind of what you expect in an 0-2 count. Excellent job of the hitter to have the plate discipline to lay off of that pitch.
At the belt and fires.
Swing. He got it.
And it's a strikeout. And there's two away.
Pache goes down.
Here's Trey Turner.
Uh-huh.
The shortstop takes the ball. Just missed. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's hit a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
The Phillies trailing by three near the bottom of the seventh. Here comes a pitch. That's foul.
That's foul.
The right side keeps the AB going. And here it comes. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Struck him out. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout.
Big strikeout for Keegan. Yeah, we have no lefties.
Ladies and gentlemen, back here with my pal Ziggy. On to the bottom of the eighth, another two hitter, Whit Merrifield. Bunt attempt, but that goes foul.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
Got him.
There's one away.
Move, if you can set up a good two-strike splitter with a fastball on the previous pitch, it's going to be so tough to recognize and adjust your swing to get a piece of it. Clearly had him reaching for it right there.
That one misses, and that is ball one. Look out. That fastball drilled him.
Well, the right side is that that will help the on-base percentage a little bit, and that's a category no batter can ignore these days. OBP, OPS, well, maybe that'll ease the pain just a little bit.
Schwarber stands in now and watches strike one.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
One ball.
The Phils trailing by three near the bottom half of the eighth inning. Line drive.
And that ball is going to be caught by Thomas. That should do it for the inning.
Thomas makes the grab, and the inning is over. Philly Street, we're back, and on the mound is the closer, Jose Alvarado. So digging in, Bryson Stott, and a pitch, and a foul ball. A 6-3 righty. He features a four-seam fastball, a splitter, a slider, and he occasionally uses a curve. Thomas makes the play, and there's one away. Edmundo Sosa digs in now. Now one out to right. Thomas under it. Makes the catch for the out.
And there's Sudow.
So they're down to their final out. Now it's going to be Johan Rojas. This one smoked out to left.
Rosario's there. Nationals win.
Nationals win the rubber match of this three-game series.
This is a huge win. Take this series on the road before heading back home. You go home feeling good about yourselves. You've got some good momentum. But at home, you also have a higher expectation to play well. So they're going to have to maintain the focus.
Pirates want to give me Grandal for Nunez. He split the series with Atlanta. Dude, so 6 points of control. Anyway, that'll do it. For this episode, hope you all enjoyed it. Have a good one, and I'm out. Bye.